A knife collection, all available.
Everything's for sale. Absolutely.
Yeah, we're going to go through some of this stuff, man. I'm excited to be here. Excited to check out some of this stuff I've never seen before.
This is the absolutely brand new Microtech Tachyon in Incredible Hulk finish.
Yeah, dude,
it is awesomely green with a little bit of splash of purple.
Yeah,
that's
cool.
That just came in. Very, very cool piece. Variation. They've been doing, there's a Superman one, there's a Hulk one, I think there's a Batman one, which is like a black and yellow.
Wait, Batman?
Yeah.
Where?
Right here, actually.
So, now you got my attention.
This is a super, super cool of Microtech to do a variant run on the Tachyon for superhero fans out there.
Knife Trader, you want to see the Geisha? All right.
Yeah, if anybody wants to see anything, just call it out.
Yeah.
The whole PVK inventory on
hand
right now.
What up, Muhammad Nizami?
Yes.
Murphy Lamar, are you the man? Can I like a comment? If I could, I'd like your comment right
now. Throw up like a little heart.
Yeah.
Bam.
This is really freaking cool. Batman Edition Tachyon 3. I'm a Batman fan, so I'm a fan.
Dark Knight for life.
So, somebody, who wants to see...
who wants to see Geisha?
Lucy in the house.
You need to get Lucy there to show.
What's up, my dude? That's Blade Runner Systems in the house right now.
Oh, BRS.
Yeah, BRS. What's up, man? So here's one of the geishas. This one's really, really cool. Lasered back, wave pattern, traditional Japanese. I'm really, really into this. Geisha, really beautiful on the front. Lasered blade. This is really cool.
The laser on the black is a super contrasty.
Yeah,
those came out really nice.
See that?
We did these full laser blades in house. These take forever. This is like a 6-hour laser process.
Wow.
The laser it hits the steel at different angles, and it brings out
the contour of the blade.
Some color. Oh yeah.
Right. Yeah, you can see the different colors in there. This is really cool. I really like this blade style too, the Spartan.
That's super nice.
It's like menacing.
The double tanto on that
is
pretty awesome.
Yeah.
And that new wave pattern definitely came out really nice. Super happy with that.
Yep, love it. Jake the Snake, what's up, man? Yeah, which one do you want to see up close? Nelson, Leia. Love. And do that. What am I supposed to do? Yeah, that. Okay. Which one you want to see up close? You want to see
oh my God, there's somebody.
The geisha.
Remember, Brad, there's a little delay.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a delay, so we'll just work it. What to do? Oh, rooster fish. What's up, man? Oh, I wish I had my cleaver song with me. Violet Crimes needs a new knife. Oh, we gotta get we gotta find a purple OTF. Give me a purple OTF for Violet Crimes right now.
Oh, we have a...
You have a geisha.
I have a purple geisha. Let me grab it.
Violet, I got you. Okay, Jake the Snake, you want to see... Or I think he just showed
you. Oh, here we go.
Violet.
Look at that.
This is amazing.
What's the serial number on the back?
So, I gotta wait just a second here to see where we're at.
Wow, it's a total blur.
Yeah, that's okay. Violet, geisha model. It's got the laser geisha on the blade. Half serrated. Really cool, obviously, double action. Push up, deploys, pull down. It's away. This is for you, Violet. Yeah, she says, holy sexy. Damn right.
Boom.
Yeah, I'm a fan.
We just got this, I was showing you this earlier, this Vegas Forge Damascus.
Oh, Vegas Forge makes some cool stuff.
Spirograph Damascus. So that's really cool. That
get out of here.
That Damascus is made like basically down the street.
Yeah, the Vegas Forge.
Yeah,
they're pretty close here to PVK actually.
That turned out great.
This is amazing. That's, I gotta
like Sean's new grind on that Hellhound. I don't know. I'm a huge fan. I absolutely carry the Ultratech Hellhound in DLC. Like, what a great variation on the Tonto, you know?
It's super unique looking. Absolutely. The swedge is really cool. The heavy jimping on the top is insane.
Absolutely.
Super aggressive. And I really like the contrast of this midnight blue, the detail that he's got going in here. And this is a carbon fiber show side.
Go slow.
Really, really cool. Glass breaker with rings that are highlighted in blue. With all blue ringed hardware.
The ported beast. Blade on the Hellhound is super neat. I think that's also a very...
Yeah, the little ports in there.
Little holes in there. That's pretty cool.
Yeah,
I like that.
A lot.
Those are really nice. What else we got here? We got these...
Willie Nelson's son. What's up, man? I think you do, Violet. Yeah, let me know. I can bring one of these home for you.
Ooh.
Lion Tribe wants to see one of the red ones.
Red Geisha?
Yeah, so actually, Lion Tribe, we've got the Geisha, which I'll show you a close-up of, and then also a kind of a new model of Samurai, which when I first got the Samurai, probably over a year ago, everybody went really nuts over it. I went nuts over it myself, which is why I love it so much. But this one's really, really cool. Okay, I'm gonna get up here for you so you can see it.
Get up close.
Yeah. Full laser blade. It's got like a dragon. Yeah. And then the samurai on the handle there with the really old, cool hardware. The hardware itself is very samurai-like, or ancient Japan crest, which is why I loved it so much, just the details. And then the wave on the back. It's two-tone, red and black, which I really love. It kind of matches the Janus here, which you guys have seen me carry. It's the dual-wielding Nuck. Split it apart, now you got dual-wield.
Totally awesome original design.
Yeah, it's extremely cool. I love it. Everybody else that I show loves it, too.
Is that right?
Yeah, but this is a cool pair. Yeah.
Black and red.
Yeah.
Oh, man. See that?
Badass.
That's legit.
So hopefully you guys see that. The carbon fiber one. The carbon fiber one's, yeah.
Oh, that's like real, absolutely
real impressive. Seatbelt cutter, no, but it should cut through a seatbelt without having a seatbelt cutter. This, I think a seatbelt cutter would actually be a step lower.
Oh, yeah, like a shroud cutter almost?
Yeah.
That'll absolutely cut through a seatbelt. That'll cut through like...
100%.
Yeah, no problem.
You can see that again.
Let's throw this down here.
Did you guys notice the table? Strider?
Custom Strider table?
Yeah, custom Strider table.
That was from Gathering 1 year ago, last year? No, 2 years ago from the Gathering we got
the
that.
The white one. Oh, Stormtrooper.
Stormtroopers. So these are awesome new double-edged Stormtroopers. We've got that in combat and the Ultratech version. The white on white is just like, it's striking, you know? It's a real contrast to like all the black knives out there. Just a solid white, you know? And it's got the Imperial logo on the back, which is, you know, you gotta love that.
Yeah, I love the Imperial.
Just evil all up in there. We got some pouches here. What's in these pouches right now? What's going on?
Yeah, what are in those pouches? Truly, I honestly, guys, I have no idea what is in these pouches. You know, the PVK guys they just set these out, and I'm like, oh, we're gonna explore together.
Okay, so this came in. I didn't even get to take a look at it. We're gonna take a look at it right now for the first time. This is an absolutely earth-shattering. New.
It must cost a fortune to license all that Disney property. Stop it.
Stainless. Uh-oh. Disney property, what are you talking about?
Yeah, what are you talking, this doesn't, yeah, no.
Nuh-uh, not at all.
I have no idea what you're talking about. What? Oh, Jesus Christ.
So right now, this is a stainless steel dual action OTF from Burn Knives with abalone inlay in the front and back. Was a ultra custom ridge slider switch, which absolutely hammers out a mirror polished full ported blade.
You guys see that, all right?
It's pretty serious.
This is serious. Yeah, Jesus. Can you all see yourselves in that?
Yeah, mirror reflection of the camera. Can you guys see yourselves in that?
Wow.
That's.
I wish you could hear that. Actually, there's no way the microphone on my phone is gonna pick that sound up. The way that it is in person. Yeah, this is like, it's got like this little shink sound. It's like when you taste something really good and you get that really good aftertaste. That's a
great description.
That's what I'm experiencing with this insane double auto knife right now. It's like heavy duty and then it just has that ring. Yeah.
The stainless steel, like the stainless steel chassis, like really, like it almost echoes like the internal mechanics of that knife.
Yeah, I feel like if it was just pitch black and you were worried, yeah, and then you just hear that, you're like, oh, yeah, no, I need to go hide somewhere.
Right, like, I don't know. So Paul, who makes Burn, Paul is Burn, he's been developing this OTF over the last probably like 5 years, and this is definitely like the coolest version I've seen.
I haven't seen anything like that before.
These are amazing, actually. I have, so that's, he called that the Vengeance.
Really cool.
I have that in a couple different.
Can go down. What's up, man?
Thank you.
Andrew Cohan. Hey.
That's great. It's absolutely. We're doing Instagram Inception today, so we're.
Yeah.
We're trying to get as many live as possible. Oh yeah, that's all the live feed. We are monitoring your comments as best as possible. All right, so this is another.
Is that got a cobra on it?
Yeah, this is a totally awesome. Another Vengeance by Burn. I see that. It has this really sweet cobra on the front. Very cool. Also the cobra on the back. Which is totally awesome.
Yeah, whoa. Yeah, let me show. What I think is really cool. I don't know if you guys can see this or not, but the blade just tucks right in, and I mean it's right there and it's crafted identical to the ridge here in the handle, so the blade is literally right there. What if I like shoot this out at you guys? This one's really cool.
Yeah, the Vengeance series is like, he started doing like a Viper series. And the Vengeance is just the absolute, like, double XL, like, super hardcore stainless version of that.
It's heavy duty. Whoa, that was close.
So, stainless steel Palm Viper, that's slightly smaller, but similar theme. Burn really likes to do the abalone inlays, which come out really great.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Really nice contrast on a stainless knife. And so it's like there's a little skull on the switch, which was a super nice touch. It really adds to like the 3D personality of the front of that.
Yeah, I love it.
Tiny little skull right there. That's all right. There we go.
It's, Willie Nelson's son still in the house for the Strider here.
Ooh, look at that. That is nice. I'm definitely a fan of that Palm Viper. Where's that one in there? What happened? You what? Oh, you flipped it. Oh, there we go. We're just flipping that.
This Stormtrooper is massive.
Where we got people joining?
New large Stormtrooper versus the original one.
Oh.
We got people joining. Go slow.
Yeah.
That's all right.
My thumb's gonna be worn out after like the next few minutes.
All the dual action mechanisms.
What's up, guys? Got some new joiners. We're over here at PVK Vegas checking out some really cool customs, some amazing microtechs. bunch of really amazing geisha OTFs, dual action. Got this really cool Strider sitting here. We'll show you in a minute, because the other side of the blade is definitely worth checking out. It's really impressive. Sorry, service is in and out. Red ones on the website, I don't see them. We got red geishas on the website yet? Probably not.
No.
Not yet.
They're not up yet.
No.
But
there's some blue ones up there with Spartan blades.
Spartan blade blue ones are up.
These will be up Monday.
These are all the geisha that we just did are absolutely just finished, and most of these are going to be one of a kind. We did go all out, so most of them are the contoured chassis Ultratech, aside from these totally awesome Samurai, which are flat body. But we have these in like purple, OD, black, red, all with the beautiful front geisha, and completely different blade setup, full serrated, partially serrated, black, Spartan. We're working to get them up as soon as possible because they are a hotly wanted item.
Oh yeah,
we are super psyched about how they came out.
Yeah, if you can't tell from the videos, I mean, the work on this is just beautiful. I'm a fan.
That pretty new wave pattern we did.
Yeah, the back is really cool with that wave detail. What do you got in your hand there, man?
Okay, yeah, I brought this up. This is totally, people love this. So this is the auto stitch. This is the adaptation of Sebastian's manual stitch in automatic form, and it just, it rockets out of
there. Yeah, let me see this thing.
That's pretty sweet. Super premium blade steel on that too, for a production level knife.
And it's really solid.
Oh, it's super beefy.
Really, really solid. All right, I'm gonna deploy this thing. Yeah. Oh, I like the dual jimping.
Yeah, they did a really good job with that. Like,
this M390.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite blade steels.
For a production knife, that's great.
Yeah.
That's really nice. Finish work on that apocalyptic blade, right?
Yeah. We were talking about that earlier.
Yeah, apocalyptic is like, I love that. You use it like, you know, you don't even notice. You just beat away at it, totally fine. You don't even notice.
Yep, exactly. I'm never afraid to use my stitch just because it's got the apocalyptic finish, and you know, you can never tell when it's used.
Terry, who's the guy on Instagram?
It's got a like that crack finish. Who? Which one?
I'm trying to think of.
So nice.
Like breathtaking blades? Epic blades? Epic blades.
Epic blades? Yeah.
Epic blades?
What's you want me to text that guy right now?
I'm going
to
text him.
Is he on here? Is that microphone?
No.
Fire. Thanks, Swix27.
Stitch Auto, totally awesome. Oh, it's Steve Katana. Hey, what's up, dude? Stitch Auto, yeah. Totally
yeah, if you guys ever want to see, if you want to see something here at the studio up close, let me know. I'll jump up and grab it from the glass and show you guys a close-up. We've been kind of doing that since we started this live feed.
I got one, Brett. I bet you haven't seen it. This new Paragon Gravity Blade.
What the hell is that?
Okay, so this is a new knife from Paragon that not that many people are familiar with, but is building steam on the internet. Paragon, right there.
Yeah, I'm not familiar with that at all. So
it's a totally...
Enlighten me.
It's a closed case design. You don't see any blade at all. And what you do is you pinch the top and the bottom pivot.
Oh, what the hell?
And it splits the whole knife in half, and then once the knife is open, gravity swings the blade out, and almost like a ballet song, one movement, you pop it and let it go, and the knife closes itself, so when you grab it, there's no seam or anything. I mean,
wow.
There's a seam,
let me see
there's no handle. And that's,
did you guys see that?
That's pretty neat. That has a compound grind on it.
I love the compound grind.
But it, like... The knife industry doesn't do too much with gravity blades. You know, I mean, okay, Bally Song is debatably sort of like a gravity blade.
Yeah, sure.
But, like, that's an absolutely cool actual gravity
blade.
Oh,
wow. Knife. I didn't quite do it.
So, yeah. So exactly. It clicks itself shut. Super neat. It's really nice to see.
It's extremely cool.
Yeah.
Did you guys see that? Push it in, splits in half.
Warlock, exactly. Yep, Paragon Warlock.
Now we're ready to go.
Everybody wants to see that Super Matrix.
Oh yeah, that Super Matrix is insane.
That's next level.
How much for the green butterfly knife? Oh yeah, that's the Incredible Hulk. You see it back there? We were kind of looking at that at the very beginning of the feed, but we'll go back to it because it is really, really cool. Incredible Hulk, Tachyon 3. It's very, very cool. This looks almost black, but it's a very, very dark midnight purple. Very Hulk. It's super cool. I love it. And yeah, what did these run?
About 350.
Yeah, they're in the threes. And so you've got bearings, which makes it really smooth. And I don't know if any of you have ever handled the Tachyon 3 yet, but it's a...
This is really cool, actually. I love it. You've got the milled out parts there so it can clear it and whatnot. Really amazing design.
I have to check, but I bet you the original Pacific Cutlery had ported handles like
ported
that.
Ported handles,
yeah,
too, yeah.
I would imagine that's exactly why Paul did that. It's just to be like, look, this is an homage to early Valley Song creation.
Yeah, this is really, really cool, guys. Wow. Amazing stuff over here. PVK. I'm so happy to be able to check some of these out. Let's see. I'll show you guys this. We got Strider fans in the house. Really? Mick Striders. So, looks like we've got a MM Gear / Tai 2 design. Mike Bond over there at Tai 2. I'm sure all of my followers follow him. He's a really cool guy and he makes some very amazing stuff. So it's got the American bead on here, and this is the Mick Strider, American guy with making these knives. And then this is a Captain America. It doesn't get any more American than this.
Super double, triple, quadruple patriotic.
Yeah, quadruple patriotic. So I'm gonna hold this up closer to the camera for you guys because it's really, really impressive. You've got the American flag on the handle here with like these deep blue, almost purple hardware. The bead is really awesome. And then a cap. So Steve Rogers, Steve is here holding the American flag on the blade. I don't know if you guys can see that one. Let me see here.
So that knife has actually a pretty neat history.
Oh, really? Yeah. Tell me about
so,
it.
So that knife actually existed only in parts for a while, and was sort of assembled.
Assembled?
Yeah.
Avengers assembled?
Avengers assembled for PVK in collaboration with Josh from Strider. We're always in search of. Yep.
Yeah, this guy mentions Greg Lightfoot, who actually I second. Very, very cool. Kirby Lambert, everybody knows him.
Kirby.
Steve, Nova Blades. I actually have a Nova Blade custom, you guys. I haven't posted it in a while. But I love it. His work is really, really cool and good. So definitely see some Nova Blade stuff so they can get a couple of pieces thrown up there for you guys. But yeah, cool. I'm glad somebody asked about Nova Blades. I love that guy's work. So what else do you guys want to see?
Always in search of new talent. We got new stuff on the way.
Yeah, we'll bring out some more from the knife vault.
From the vault of many blades.
Yeah, the vault of many blades. What is that an acronym for? Or what is that an acronym? Vault of many blades, VAMB. Yeah.
That's not terrible. Vault of many blades.
Yeah, I kind of like it. It's kind of like D&D-ish.
I could hashtag it on our sign and people would be like, what does that mean? But then you guys know what it means.
Yeah, so yeah, right. Exactly. Garza in the house. Very cool. Little maker from my hometown, actually.
Is that right?
Yeah, my hometown, Fresno, California.
Oh, we got some Paul stuff. Good.
And yeah, Garza's up over there with Matt Kuchihara, too. He's a really cool maker. If you guys haven't seen him, I love Matt. Nice, super duper nice guy. What's up, man?
Uh-oh.
What else do we got here?
I got.
Put your Boba Fett away.
I got Strider presents for everybody.
Oh. Still have Strider. Strider fans in the house.
Still have Strider fans in the house?
Surely. What is this? It's like sniper gray.
Super awesome.
This is killer. Black hardware. Yeah, you guys are gonna love this. What is that? Oh yeah, the Texture G10. Let me see that.
Double, so they call this
I'm gonna set this out.
Double gunner grip on that one.
Yeah, so gunner,
G10 gunner titanium.
I
have yet to have a gunner texture titanium strider. I think
it's
that
nice
needs to change.
It's like very textured. It really holds your hand.
Yeah.
Like, oh, that feels good.
Yeah, as you guys probably already know, striders are very good users. You can abuse the living hell out of these things, and they just continue to work.
Great battle knives, right?
Yeah, totally.
Designed for battle, or, you know, or everyday street battle, man. Like, on your person, cutting stuff, getting it done at the work site. Like,
yeah, I feel like I can be, like, building a house, and I need to, like, pry some bricks apart, and I'll just
cut down
like,
a whole tree with an SMG. I'm sure somebody's done that out there. Like,
yeah, and it just closes just like nothing happened.
SMG versus SMF, both are awesome. SMG, great in the pocket, though.
Yeah, you know
great
what?
In the pocket. Even with guys, like, you don't have small mitts. I mean, you've got pretty
yeah.
sizable hands.
Well, and everybody's seen my Rad Knives Field Cleaver, which I love, and, like, the Dalibors that I have, and I love them. But I swear, I love the SMG. It's, like, the perfect EDC. I mean, you can kind of see how it fits in my hand there. It's, you got the little choil.
Strider loves those choils.
Yep.
Choke up on that blade for maximum manipulation like that.
Oh.
Yep. Yep, it's really good. This is like the perfect little EDC here. So yeah, I really love it. A lot of my followers have probably seen my Prometheus Design Works SMG that I have. I love that.
That's right, you have one of those.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, and it's an SMG, and I carry it all the time. It's got the gun-finished blade on it, the chromium nitride.
I've seen that in your feed. That has,
yeah.
that has beautiful laser work.
Yeah,
it.
Yeah,
that
really good.
Has...
It's got the topographic detail.
That.
Yeah. So, I love SMGs. This, I love this. This is killer. I'd like to send this off to, like, Rotten Designs or CMF Metalworks or Metal Morphosis, one of those guys to do some cool flame work on there. Something would be
so
really cool.
That's the SMG with the gunner grip and black blade. So just
a little
variant from that guy.
This is a Z-Wear.
Yeah. Yep.
I think I'm gonna have to take this Z-Wear home with me. What do you guys think? Yeah, Z-Wear. I gotta have this.
That Z-Wear is pretty tight. That's
yeah.
Like...
Who's one of my buddy? Knife Predator. Knife Predator has had a Z-Wear and he swears by it. And I think he put it up for sale and it sold the same day or within a couple of days or something. And I was really kind of bummed because I've been hearing really good things about the Z-Wear. But there's one in my hand right now.
I don't
now.
Have that much experience with that. With that.
That blade steel.
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess it's pretty rare. Like, I mean, I don't say rare isn't rare, but like in the knife world, I don't think you see it used a lot. On blades, but apparently it holds up really well, has great edge retention, and yeah, this is actually extremely sharp. Although I will say, every strider I've ever opened up has been like, you know, it'll just shave your hair like with
like,
that.
I looked
yeah.
at it and my eyeball sliced in half.
Yeah,
what
yeah exactly.
How did that happen? That's,
hey,
like,
don't
that's sharp. That's proper sharp.
Yeah.
All right, Z-Wear. I'm going to totally Google that. I'm unfamiliar. That's pretty neat. I mean,
yeah.
It's nice to see makers, you know,
yeah,
on any level, just why not use every steel available, right?
Yeah, exactly.
There are awesomely popular steels, you know, everybody's got their favorite, but just shoot it up.
Well, Willie Nielsen, what's up, my dude? You want to see the Steve Rogers First Avenger?
Oh.
My man Steve Rogers, Captain America, right there, American flag. I love the bluish purple hardware. And sorry for guys that are seeing this again, but Willie Nelson's son chimed in, and he's a good friend of mine, so I gotta show him this thing. But yeah, so there you go. Amazing. The CRP spinner, right? Oh, CKF, you mean? Yeah, it is so good. Actually, you're short like three O's. You put so good, but it's
good.
So good.
So good.
Yeah.
Guys, when you show, pan all of them, okay?
Yeah, all three.
When you show, pan all three.
Yeah.
This is the one you can see in that monitor right there.
Oh, cool. We do really have like this Inception thing going on. I can see myself like in the mirror. And
there's just...
Sorry,
a complete
I you were
triple inception
my...
going on.
But,
the spinner project. Oh, actually, no, I wasn't. But yeah, I love that thing. Oh, Garza chimed in. Brett, don't sneak that one in your pocket. Cam, what's up, man? You know that's probably gonna happen, but I won't escape out of here. These guys are the real deal.
The real deal right now.
Yeah.
I got some more Striders.
Give me all the Striders in the whole world.
So we
have a whole box right there.
We graduated. We graduated from SMGs to SMFs.
I want to see that SMF.
These are so nice. Okay, so this, you were asking me about this earlier. So this carbon fiber, but the Loctite is contoured. It's not the standard flat Strider. See that? It's really like that was designed to be in the hand. Like that. That's a really nice. I like that one. That's a personal.
I absolutely love this. Actually, this is. Just holding this one right here is really making me want to go search out one of the nightmare grind in this contour. You know, a couple of my buddies have those knives and vapes. Cool dude. Yeah. He's got a really great Strider collection.
Are you saying that Knives and Vapes has some Striders?
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah. What? Betrunken one, good buddy of mine. He's got some really great Striders, and yeah, I do not. I've never owned one of these contoured handles, and I gotta say it's
pretty comfy,
it's
right?
Huge, yeah, it's
nice.
It's definitely, I want to get one now. I'll make sure you guys can see this. A lot of you guys probably already know, but to some of the guys that don't, and then the carbon fiber handle, that's all me. You guys know that I'm a carbon fiber nut, carbon fiber Mokuli. Let's show some of these other cameras over here too. Sorry, it's getting blurry. There we go.
I'll try it.
Oh, here, let's go. Yeah, you want to pass over there?
Oh, so that's,
this has got the Tonto grind.
Look at that.
Yeah, check this out. Did you already show them these?
That one on that one.
Yeah, that contoured handle is huge.
That's pretty nice.
Absolutely love it.
Sits real comfy in the hand.
Yep.
Nice job, fellas.
Mick, if you're watching, I love this.
Oh, that's Chris.
But yeah, it's Chris, huh?
Other Chris. Shop Chris.
Is this Strider Knives Josh?
Yes.
Yeah.
These are pretty nice. See, carbon fiber. You know, carbon fiber, excellent addition, G10. Awesome to see synthetics on there.
Yeah, I love it.
You've got a box on your side. I've got some fixed blades here. These are like nice, small.
Yeah, Cam, that Tonto's cool.
So this is Strider's line of EDC fixed blades that he designed. These are totally awesome. What's going on right now? What's going on right now?
Oh, guys.
What is going on right now? That is a two-handed, I'm going to say just under a Wakasashi, really big Tonto.
Oh man,
that is.
You guys seeing this?
That is a beautiful hammer on that too. That's really nicely done. Even throughout the blade, that's.
All right, so this is something else I need.
Right.
I forgot to bring my my other checkbook. You know. Check this out, guys.
That's a battle device right there. That's very serious.
Signed by Mick.
Signed by the man himself.
The hammer. Well,
that could probably get. Where that ends up on.
Right there, that car. Or there.
You guys see this? Oh, sorry. But yeah, this is insane. I've never seen one of these. I didn't even know this existed, actually, to be 100% honest with you. This is wild. You guys gotta love that.
Yeah, that's...
That's no joke.
This is a great... I mean, this is... Thick as heck too. I mean, this is a solid piece of.
Yeah, I feel like I could pry open the gates of heaven with that thing, which I'd probably need to do.
Yeah, no, that's a standard operating procedure for Saturday night parties.
Yeah,
is drag in a Volkswagen Beetle and cut it in half with a Strider.
Oh, hey, we gotta do that.
WTF is going on right now?
All right, so I wasn't privy to the fact that there. Are some of the most amazing Striders I've ever seen that are coming out right now, to my surprise.
So I mean, this is absolutely right now debatably, undebatably on PVK. I think we have the largest rare collection for sale right now. Like that right there, that piece. Oh, I showed you one. That's beautiful. Like,
okay,
that's,
I'm gonna have to give you guys a close up of this because this is absolute insanity. Look at these.
2 for 2 on that one, huh?
What? Are you guys seeing this?
All right, do some close ups. Look at this.
Yeah, wow.
The Damascus on these short swords, fixed blades.
You see this like raw, rough, flat, and then the compound grind. I mean, Mick, I'm in awe right now.
Right? Like fist bump, man. Like this is amazing.
And PVK, good lord. I mean, they just keep impressing me every other minute with these things. You guys seeing that? Check this out.
We're gonna swap here because I want to see this insane sword.
Swap.
Woo! So even the handguard is Damascus. The hilt. Man. You guys seeing this?
The collar on that scale, one. I love that. Such a nice touch, you know.
My brother is African American, so I don't hate anyone. Look actually.
Remember, this is gonna be on my TV. This will get
Cleveland Brown. Stop being a weirdo, dude. Check out the compound grind on this. Holy F is right, and yeah, Cam. Cobalt Damascus. Look at this. This is bonkers.
Yeah, these.
So I'm just gonna go take this out on the strip right now. We'll see how long it takes me to go to jail, and I'll be back in an hour. I'm just kidding. But
you know, it's Vegas. You no problem, man.
Just, yeah, probably.
As long as you're not concealed, you're totally fine.
Yeah.
And as soon as they hear it's a Strider, then you're even better.
Yeah, then you're even
like,
better.
Oh, in that case, get out of here. That's perfect.
Yep. Gotta love how that works. You guys seeing this?
That's perfect, though.
I mean, I didn't even know Mick did stuff like this. That shows you how out of tune I am with some of Mick's work. Marissa, if you're listening, I apologize. For those of you who don't, Marissa is Mick's wife. She is extremely cool, very nice lady. Wow.
Yeah, that's...
So this is out of the knife vault.
That's
are
like,
these available?
Yeah, that's absolutely available. That is absolutely available. Ready to go.
We gotta ask Josh how much this is.
That's a future pirate ancient sword.
I like that. Future pirate ancient sword. Yeah. So the contradiction is actually.
Well, like the Damascus
cool.
is so futuristic, but like the style I feel is like if I were a pirate, that would be my sword. Like, okay.
I'm with you on that.
Right? Like, something short is kind of, like, very easily maneuverable.
Yeah, that's right.
That just blows my mind every time I hold that. It's nuts.
Yeah, I feel like I have to go to a car dealership and buy a car and then trade the car for something like
just
this.
Just a moment.
Yeah.
Have this. And
what do you need to drive?
We are good. Yeah. Let's go ahead and trade.
Yeah, this is really, really remarkable, though, in reality here. This is crazy, man.
The far out. That's the far out piece.
Love it. Got some more Striders. Let's get in. What do we got here? Mick Strider, Starlinger, Scarecrow.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. A lot of you. I don't have it on me. No, Willie. Sorry. It's actually at home. But a lot of Strider fans are obviously Starlinger fans. This one that I'm about to open up that I keep hinting at, like I'm teasing.
Yeah, with the flame chill going on.
Yeah, yeah. Just tuned back in. What was that knife? Lord of the Hollows. What's up, man? Yeah, that was a Mick Strider custom pirate, ancient, futuristic
pirate
sword.
Yep.
Yeah, that's what we've dubbed it.
That's the other one, yeah.
Just let me know in the comments if you want me to pull it back out again. We're happy to do that. We're just having a good time here with all this. But now on to this.
Oh,
Starling
no.
here.
That one?
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. Ooh. Wow. Really incredible.
Oh,
sheath. Yeah, I put it up at the top.
Okay,
all right. Well, I'll actually bust it out right after this.
It's such a nice touch, the leather slip on that. It's really nice.
It's really, as a matter of fact, I'm just going to get up close and show you guys. I feel like I'm doing you a disservice by opening this. We'll experience this together. So you can see the detail here. Scarecrow bead is so mean. You know, the Starling Gear work is amazing. You guys see this? Sorry guys, I'm gonna like pan over to a couple of different cameras. We're doing live feed on PVK as well, so you know, feel free to jump over in either one. You're gonna get just a different angle. So here we go. Look at this, guys. Is this thing going? Yeah, good. Nice knives. Fighter Jet 16. Is that like F-16? All right, here is the Scarecrow. I'm gonna open her up here. Yeah, this is insane.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, look at this. Spider webs on the blade.
That laser work on the lock side is just outstanding.
Does PVK want any more customs? I have a one-off SJ I'm trying to sell. Hey, you never know. Shoot an email over with a picture of it, man. Or a direct message, just shoot it over to the PVK Instagram. But yeah, so this is really great. Here, show the PVK guys this. Is this one live on the site?
Yes.
Yeah, this is live on the site right now, too.
Bead too.
Yeah, that bead is impressive. Or trade. Eyeballs. So that's the difference, is this one's an SNG and that one's an SMF.
Oh, was that
one? Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That laser work. I kicked my camera. Sorry, guys.
And that bead.
Yeah, you guys seeing that?
The beads are such a nice touch when they do collaborations. I love it.
Well, especially when they're like so detailed, you can see the quality in it. It's not just like some bead thrown on there. And these ones are themed. So that's like the Scarecrow knife with the Scarecrow bead. And then this one's really special, and I feel it's only appropriate to show you since we're showing you the Scarecrow. This is the Killer. So this is the sheath, brutal, very brutal. Got this like hockey mask, Starling Gear face bead.
Bowie, got my
feel. And then here we go.
And you're on the mess of the.
Got the multicolored G10, dripping blood, titanium, ano on the back. I really like this one because my brother, Christian, if you're watching, he's a big fan of Friday the 13th, and that's kind of what the theme is on this one. Oh, it looks like our live feed timed. Are these timed? I had no idea.
Oh, yeah, it looks like they are.
So we'll, I guess, go for now, and then I'll just, like, start up a new one. So Killer SNG to be continued.
BRB.
BRB.
Can't remember.
Yeah. All right, guys. We're going to log back in here and boop. Start live video.
Yeah, get more energy.
I know.
After this one, take a break. Remember, whatever followers you think you got on Instagram.
Booyah.
We'll see lots of people on those, too.
All right, so we're back. We had to take a little break because I guess these live videos. This, FYI, this is the first time I've ever done a live video, so you know, it's new to me. So the fact that it just started timing out, I was like, oh, that's really bizarre. But yeah, so this is the Killer SNG. I just picked this one up. So it's not on PVK.com anymore, but there are
a lot, and we'll get through some more of these. There are a lot of really amazing striders on PVK.com.
That's where you need that.
So, yeah, feel free. Like, watch this from your phone and then jump on your laptop and go to the website and you can kind of see stuff. And if you see something on the website that you want to see, like an action video of or whatever on the live feed,
oh yeah,
just shoot me a comment. And we're happy to run out to the front or go into the vault or whatever and pull something out.
Wherever the knives may be.
Very accommodating. So
if anybody wants to see anything, we'll just grab it.
Did you show the PVK guys these?
Awesome. This is
gone.
Totally beautiful. Sold out. Don't worry about it. You can't drool. It already belongs to Brett. It's his.
But the Captain America one is still available, I believe.
Yep.
Which I really, really love.
If
I could just, like...
If I could own all the knives.
Yeah.
If I could have all of them, then this would be in the ones that I would have.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, wow. I haven't opened this in a bit.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Hmm.
But yeah.
This was a East Coast Custom.
The East Coast Custom Knife Show exclusive, I think. Chilly. Was it last year? Yeah, I love the...
That's such a nice touch.
Yeah, the dripping blood. Again, you know, when I saw this knife, my little brother is one of my favorite people in the whole world, and he is a huge, he's a huge Jason Voorhees fan. I know that sounds kind of scary, but he's a really cool kid, actually. So as soon as I saw this, I was like, God, Mick Strider and Strider Knives, I mean, and SNG, freaking... Starling Gear with the Jason Voorhees kind of horror deal. You know, I found out a couple years ago, so I don't know how long they've been doing it, but a couple years ago I found out that Starling Gear was doing these collabs with like the horror theme, I should say. I mean, so it's the collab between Strider Knives and Starling Gear, and then they did these horror themes. I think there's like a
Scarecrow Jason.
Then this one's obviously like Friday the 13th, which was a big deal. And God, there were a few others.
Can't think of them. Who remembers? Who remembers out there?
Willie Nelson's son probably knows. He's like, Cody.
That's yours.
Oh, yeah. What's up, Cody? Dwayne is making me a knife now. Awesome. Wait, what does it say? Just found. Oh, I got to scroll up, Cam. Just found the price on that MSC fixed. Oh, heartbroken. I don't know. What is it? I know. I was thinking I would probably have to trade in a car or sell a car to get that thing. Yeah. So I'm going to leave this here. And anybody who wants to see this, you know, feel free to chime in. How do we... Come on. Give me a second.
Stub there.
That's pretty... There we go. What is that one?
That's the
Gibble?
Yeah. Or no, this is the stub. Or is this the Gibble?
Yeah.
This pouch has the wrong.
Yeah, that's a Gibble.
Wrongly velcroed.
Oh wait, no. But what? This is cool. What is this?
I would love to do.
This is wild.
I would love like that.
This feels good.
That is a wonderful titanium scale that I would just love to laser.
Yeah, no kidding. Except for it's already like a special edition.
Like it's so tempting. Like the laser work, it's like a just a canvas you want to just cover.
Yeah, you just want to get your art deal going. And
but that's super comfy.
This is cool.
It's like a really nice.
Yeah, you guys see that?
That sits perfect in the hand.
Yes. This is awesome. This is like, is this the chromium nitride? I think it might be, or at least it's some sort of, it's just nitrate.
It might be.
Really cool. You know, you guys know me, I'm super into firearms.
Is there a slip? Gosh, a slip.
Who knows what logo this is?
I guess it's just DLC, it says.
But oh, is it DLC? Like DLC? Oh, yeah.
It's really nicely done, DLC.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Like super nice.
Click. What do we got here? Justin, I'm going to whip you. Hey, you guys are hilarious. Tony, that's my real G right there. Tony, Thug Knife.
Oh, Thug Knife.
Yeah,
Yeah, he's a good friend of mine. What's up, man? We're over at PVK.
Hanging out.
Valknut logo, that's what it is. Thanks, Willie. Yeah, PVK out in Las Vegas. Hop in your gas-guzzling 7 Series BMW with your 35-inch chrome wheels, you pretentious jerk, and get out here.
The wheels, though, they help with the gas mileage and the speed, right?
Yeah, that's what I hear. I mean, he can at least speed and then tell the cop,
right.
Well, did you see my obnoxious wheels?
Look at the wheels, though.
Yeah.
Look at the wheels and understand the power
yeah.
that it comes from the
that's,
side.
That's Thug Knife I'm talking about. I really love Thug Knife, actually. I give him shit, he gives me shit, and but he's real.
See, that's the fun of it. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's the fun of it.
Yeah.
What else you got over there?
Yeah, let me see. We got some really
Striders cool. Striders on your side. I'm going to pull up a couple of these. What do you got?
You guys want to see more Striders. I know you do. Because I do too. Oh, we got the murder in the house right here.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, this is bad.
Oh, jeez. Oh, that's right. Yep.
Yeah, full murdered out.
The official murder edition?
Yeah. Yeah, you know. We like using that term.
Black on black on black on black, dipped in black.
Yeah, with a little bit of
black. Just wait for it. Sprinkle
300 blackout ACOG. Hey, yeah, thanks, Strider Art. I still haven't picked up that ACOG, but yeah, I'm going to. You guys see this one? This is the murdered out Strider SMF. In CPM 154. Are these all up? I can't imagine these are all up. So, but if they are,
most of these are up.
Yeah, SMGs are some of them are up.
So SMFs aren't up yet. SMGs are up.
Yeah, there's about.
Yeah, there's some of them are up. They will all be up very soon.
Yeah.
Shortly after this video, when everyone's screaming, they will absolutely be up.
Yeah.
That's the.
Yeah, so we'll probably start working on that in real time. But yeah, this one's really nasty. Yeah, I love that. What is
going
that?
On right now?
What is that?
This is this is absolutely a very rare Strider, which at first glance might be not that big of a deal. This is a Strider push or punch dagger, depending on your terminology, that we have picked up. Super rare Strider.
Let me see.
Very comfy. Fits in the palm like a plum. That's super neat. Ooh,
yeah, I think I need one of these.
That is real. That is a particularly nice double-edged grind on that.
Yeah, it is.
You know, which is why that's so neat too, is you really don't see that double edge from Strider that much. You really don't.
Yeah, this is amazing. It just feels good. Well, I got my whatever Louis kind of clanking around in there.
Whatever.
Yeah, whatever. What's up, Louis, if you're watching.
If you're out there
yeah.
in Instagram land.
Yeah. This is amazing. Wow. Where's the, do you have the sheath?
Oh, yeah.
Super Kydex.
Super Kydex.
Yeah, that's badass.
Oh, snap.
What do you got
Uh-oh.
There? What do you got
I don't
there?
Know, Brett. This is a...
Oh,
jeez.
We keep going crazy. Yeah.
Sit down for a moment.
All right.
So, guys, this is a... I don't even know. This is between the Inception and the Knives. This might break Instagram. So this is actually... This is a totally...
I know, it's terrible.
Totally amazing Monkey Muster find. This is the Mixed Rider XL Damascus Tonto with Stellite Core Damascus.
Oh, boy.
Which is just, like, probably up there in flashiness.
Oh, thank you.
With,
Oh, what?
It's definitely up there in flashiness with that Matrix. You know, it's an extra large, and it's absolute. It's just ooh.
I like that new little like dimple deal he's putting at the very end of the chip.
Look at that! Thank you.
I think it gives it a cool look.
That is, I mean, if you want SMF, talk about an XL. That Stellite Core Damascus is just gorgeous.
Oh yeah,
that's gorgeous.
and it's like textures.
Like that knife, I would absolutely describe as vicious. That's
insanity.
Yeah.
M Strider.
That is live
this
right
is,
now.
This is really cool detail here. That Millie, and then it actually deletes. It just stops right here, and then so from here to here is just straight, and then you got this extra mill here. Dare I say JB Stout? No, can't do that. Jeff Blauvelt, Tough Knives.
Yep.
He joked about that because I put in an order for a Catalyst, and so he was making it. We were talking about, you know, what I wanted done to it and everything, and I wanted it clean and simple because we talked earlier today too how I use all of my knives.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I really don't, like, I'll throw them in a freaking bag, like. Bam. Yeah, I haven't done that with the Catalyst because it's pretty special, but I do carry it and use it. Mm. But anyways, he was talking about the chamfers on the sides, and he paid homage to JB Stout on those. But
really nice chamfers.
They really are. Really,
like, it fits that knife wonderfully.
It really does. Yeah, this is insane, guys. Yeah, actually, look, I'm gonna get back up and show you guys again. This is absolute insanity. I'm holding, like, I don't know, you could a used Honda Accord in my hand right now. I don't know what it costs,
that's
actually,
right.
But
late model. Yeah.
Oh, thanks, IV78. Appreciate that. Hey, we got someone from Germany, Mark Verhoeven. Nice to see you. Netherlands. Yeah, it's cool. I'm glad you guys are chiming in from all over the world. That's
what's up,
Briggs? Really freaking
what up,
cool.
Rob?
Cam, Instant Pound. He must be...
Instant Pound.
Yeah,
uh-oh.
He must be on the PVK website live. Like, as we're pulling stuff up, he's
where
like
is
searching
it? Where
it
is
out.
It? Where is it?
Yeah. 5,500, actually. Like, that really... I mean, considering my Yeti was like... I don't know, like $3,000 or maybe 28 or something like that. I can't even remember at this point, but it was close to $3,000. To get this level is crazy. I feel like that's a lot of money for a knife, and I'm sure a lot of my followers would agree. But, you know, some people who have the income and really see the art. Like, for me, something like this, I look at it and I see Mick Strider, legendary knife maker, you know, in his shop, sweating out, grinding this thing. I mean, look at these. Look at this.
The details on the extra large are amazing. The placement of the Damascus, which is an often underspoken item, but like the spine of this blade, like you were just showing, the spine is perfect. It's
right in the center, and I mean, when you're looking at a certain thickness of, you know, block of Damascus, you know, Mick is paying attention to that detail. As you can see, I mean, it's right there. You can see it. And then same with how the Damascus goes around the grind. Like, it's just unreal. Mick just has, you know, he's been doing it for years, and it just shows in all his pieces. But that's what I was getting at is, guys, with when... I hold this in my hand, you know, it's just, I feel all the hours and labor and the mentality that went into just building this freaking thing. It's more than a knife, you know, piece of art. One of my favorite little tools. The dual wheel Janus, love it. But yeah, no, we're back. We got a bunch of awesome custom knives here. This will be a teaser. This is a teaser.
That one.
Yeah, stick with us for a little bit to check those out. Some of you guys will recognize that logo. But yeah, man, we had a good break. We had we got to eat a little bit.
Stretch,
yeah. But
around, empty the tanks.
Oh, you guys saw I stole one of the stitches and took a stroll down towards the strip with it and posted it on my Instagram. That's one. That's the latest post right now. That stitch is incredible. It's actually still, it's up for sale on pvk.com right now. If that thing sells, I'm going to be really jealous. But, yeah, so anyways, guys, welcome back. Is that a custom T3? Probably. Where? We had some really cool TAC 3s up earlier.
Oh, that is...
This is not this a is custom no, TAC 3. No. You'll see what that is. It's really, really spectacular.
It's top secret till we get to it.
Yeah, yeah. I won't make you wait forever, forever, but I got some really cool stuff I want to get into. I'm a big Balisong fanatic, as a lot of my followers already know, and there's a 29 knives here, which I've yet to ever handle. So I'm really eager to open that up. I kind of want to start with that if you're
yeah,
cool
no,
with it.
let's crack yeah, open you, a 29.
As, while we were on the break, you were kind of talking about 29 knives, which yeah. got me kind of salivating, and then turns out, Chris, hey, look what we got.
Chris makes some really awesome ballet songs. His grinds are phenomenal.
Oh yeah, look at this carbon fiber inlay.
He has a real passion for Filipino weaponry, which he pours right into his grinds. And the finish on 29s is just it's really nice.
It's flawless.
It pretty much is flawless.
Yeah, yeah, I wish. I don't know if you guys can see this or not, but it's flawless. And this is like some Darth Vader or Kylo Ren. It's got just the faintest reflection of red in the carbon fiber. But speaking of the grinds, let's check this out.
Absolutely.
Oh, it's a kukri.
Yep.
Look at that.
A beefy.
Unlock your phone.
Beefy kukri.
Yeah, see that?
So you can read comments.
Yeah, this is impressive. Wow. You don't mind, I'm just gonna take a quick peek at this grind here. This is really impressive.
Like Chris's grinds at first look are like super basic. They're not flashy grinds, but the perfection when it comes to the point is just, it's amazing. Like it's a lifetime of perfecting, getting the grain out of the steel, matching up the lines. Like it's truly like down the down you
or the white one.
You can't possibly see, but down the nose of that is just it's
on the swedge.
Yeah, it's perfect. Like the way that the grind lines meet up.
Oh yeah, it's asymmetrical. It's
gorgeous, and you know, and you get the classic hidden pins that Chris does so well, so it gives it a really nice clean look. You know,
that's
really,
the first
really
thing
heavy
I noticed
flipper.
Actually, yeah, it's amazing. It's integral, obviously, it's channeled handles.
Yeah.
Jesus.
And you know, 29 and Bally Ballistics 2, small machine shop, not even a machine shop. Just, you know, just a guy hanging out on a lathe or a bridge port. I mean, this is not Haas, this is not anything like that. I mean, it's really just...
Yeah, this is really cool. So yeah, thanks, because now this is the first time I got to actually handle a 29 knives.
Super, super nice. That carbon fiber is, the red just barely like hints at you.
Yeah, it's not red at all. It's carbon fiber until you catch that little bit of a glare, and it's got red in there, which is really freaking rare. I like it. It's so cool.
Nice finish on that one. Yep. Absolutely.
Really, really good. That just unlatched because it's pretty tight.
Super, super, super tight. Those pins are in there. Absolutely. We have another Bally. If you want to stay on that.
Yeah, I'm Balisong super freak. So.
We have here is a Jones knives.
Yeah, show me that thing.
This is really nice. Now, carbon fiber. Oof.
Holy smokes.
Yeah. This is, you know, again, next level handles and just a really cool blade. Just the grind on this, just really nice.
Let me see. Ah, that's insane.
Yeah. You know, not channel handles, but you know what? Like, the dovetail on the carbon fiber is a really... It just sinks under the steel a little bit. It's really pretty.
You guys see that? That's really impressive, actually. And then I like that orange peel or kind of bark finish on the pivots too.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a really, really cool
And again,
one.
it's a beefy flipper.
It's nice and smooth, it feels like.
A little shorter, a more equal handle to blade ratio on that one.
Yeah, this is really cool. Oh, carbon fiber backspacers.
Yep. That carbon, you know, the carbon fiber is nice, latchless, it offsets the weight of the steel a little bit.
Yeah. Super cool.
Super nice.
I know, I'm pretty sure a lot of my followers are big Balisong fans too. seems like I get a lot of activity when I post butterfly knives.
Yeah, man, like butterfly knives are it's like a subsect of the knife community, but like the guys are wicked hardcore.
They are.
I know you're
hardcore. Yeah, yeah. Like, they're so passionate about it. And that's, I think we all get along. Like, I've always like had special, like played a little favoritism towards the Valley Song community, to be honest.
And, you know, you're like, all right, you guys, you're there. Yeah. I see you and you're awesome.
Oh, not just Kevin. You want to see it? Okay, yeah. Here, let me see. Yeah, you'll really appreciate this.
Oh, if it can focus.
Where'd I get that Strider table? Oh, SP Kohler, what's up? We got that Strider table at a few years ago at the gathering.
Yeah, this thing's wicked. You see those details in the inlay.
Don't know who I'm looking at.
Hopefully that helps.
So this is Brett, also known as Endless Possibilities on Instagram.
Yeah, Endless Possibles.
And this is PVK / Impera Industries, and we're taking a look at these amazing knives available on PVK.
Sweet registered nurse Casey. Hello. sorry, I didn't mean to catch you
off. No.
We're both going through the comments. Like, hey.
Yeah, right.
We can like overlap.
Like, hey, what's up?
Yeah. What's up?
Triple what's up? Triple shout outs.
Yep. Yeah, cool. Not just Kevin. I'm glad you saw that. And Antsy Droid. It is sweet. Yeah, what should we bust out next? We got so many cool things. Is that a Valley Song?
No, go ahead.
Alright, I got one more Valley Song.
Stay on that.
And this is by Hidetoshi Nakayama. I have no idea which one this is. I have not seen this before, so we're gonna see this together.
Oh, Jesus.
There you go. It just
bamboo.
It just got a little more real. That one is,
guys.
Yeah, the finites on that one are amazing.
Get out of here. Yep. I'm gonna call it a day after this. Wow.
Just, you know what? Forget it. I'm done. The latch.
Ooh. This is unreal. It's like all weighted over there. Yeah, this is unbelievable. Hand satin grind.
The finish on that blade is just, oh.
Yeah, this is nuts. Let me see if you can see some of these details to my fault. Yeah, look at this. Sup, Damister 11. Hey, what's up, man? Hey, you're always in my comments and stuff. Look at this. This is unreal. Look at the detail on the tang. So yeah, this thing is nuts. The rest of the guys, I don't know if you can. Yeah, look, you can see this really well on the video. Oh, I'm in reverse.
It's like mirrored. Which side am I on?
Yeah. Come on. There we go. You guys see this all right? Anyways, yeah, this is insanely detailed, amazing Japanese craftsmanship.
And that's a great example of a super classical Valley Song build. Push pivots, not traditional fasteners. Really harkens to like a simplicity in design, you know? If you want to take it apart or tighten it, well, you're out of luck, because it is what it is, and it's absolutely gorgeous. And there's like the hint of the steel of before.
Yeah, I love
it was round.
It like, and it trails up towards the top and then forward, obviously.
It's just finite touches, you know. It reminds you of the handles on like a Koji piece.
Yeah, absolutely.
Either one.
Yeah, Duhara's work too.
Just a quick little.
What's up, Willie Nelson? Son, not just Kevin. Was that handmade? Yes, it was. Actually, and that's what we were talking about. If you look. The hardware is actually hammered pins. It's not just screws that are screwed into this thing. Like, this guy actually hammered these pins into this thing. So, I mean, the handwork is unreal. Michelle, she's close by to me. She lives like 2 hours away from me. Her and her husband or boyfriend. I see them at Disneyland sometimes. We always cross paths when I go to Disneyland.
Is that right?
Yeah. Let's see. Can I see Tonto? Aramru Tahalando. Gosh dang, what is your deal? Your screen name. What Tonto do you want to see? You want to see what my my Shark Nuvco Japanese Tonto?
Oh, there it is.
I'm assuming. Yeah. Yeah, she's a beauty. I'll show it to you real quick, and then let's get something else
cooking.
Cooking, yeah.
It's Mokumi, pivot inlay, Mokumi pocket clip, backspacer. Edison does amazing work. But yeah,
so there you go. Anybody else? Whatever you see on the PVK.com website, if you want to see an action video of it or whatever, just make a deal in the comment. And yeah, I'll see you there, Michelle. And we'll grab it, and I'll show it on the video for sure. Can you link us the maker's Insta? Yeah, I don't know if you can do that. It's
if you're talking during.
Yeah, I don't know if you can do that, but if you're talking about the Shark Nuvco Ryu Japanese Tonto, it is at Shark N I V K O, I think. Yeah, or C O.
C O.
Yeah, yeah. I get confused because the K and Shark.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But yeah, just start with Shark, and if you follow knives and you constantly like knife stuff, it should be one of the first things to pop out. Holy crap!
So, this is an amazing, awesome ProTec Ultimate Custom Newport. So this is obviously amazing Spirograph Damascus, fully engraved titanium handle with a beautiful mother of pearl inset. Super custom automatic.
Yeah, let me see this. This is crazy.
Huge. ProTec, a good friend of PVK. Dave is in Southern California. A little machine shop that's been operating and making automatics for a really long time.
Bruce. What's that say? Bruce Shaw?
Bruce Shaw, yep. They've been cooking out autos for over 22 years. Yeah, and that's what they call like the ultimate custom. Like every piece of that knife is engraved.
Yeah, backspacer is insane.
Pretty much spend like 20 minutes just staring at the engraving. It is all done by hand. Excellent gentleman's carry.
That like mother of pearl inlaid into the button, hand inlaid into the handle.
Super fine touches on that. Even the rear pivot is engraved as well as the front pivot. Like
yeah, and they love call that
ultimate because it's really there's no yeah like. Yeah. The close-ups, oh, yeah.
It would be hard to, let me get up again. RU Knife, what's up? I see a pink tag, yeah, there is. We'll get to those here pretty soon, actually.
But yeah, here's for the YouTube guys.
Yeah,
this is insane. I love the flower engraving on the pivot. Looks like cherry blossom, kinda. Yeah, this detail's unreal. Yeah, see that all right. So yeah, this is beautiful.
And yeah, ProTec, that auto.
Set a camera too.
Yeah, this is the first one I was doing.
Was it?
Yeah. Yeah, I was watching the monitor here. But yeah, the ProTec, I can't believe how solid those things are. Oh, reminds me of the some of my favorite engineers and designers is Grant and Gavin Hawk. Those guys just kill it. They're knife
wizards, right?
Yeah, they're knife wizards. They really are. They did the no wiggle.
The deadlock.
The deadlock.
Yep.
Yeah, and I don't mean to compare ProTec to Grant and Gavin Hawk, but I just got to say I was surprised because I'm not very familiar with ProTec. That when I opened that, it was like chink. It was solid. The lockout, everything was incredible.
The tolerances on these autos are
you can tell they
are super tight. I mean it's all it's hand finished stuff.
Hey, 50 blades in the house. That's one of my favorite dudes right there. Him and Ego's Death, who I talked about earlier. knife gas. Yeah, we were just looking at some Bally songs, dude. You missed it. I hope you're still here. Becky, please. dude, we just had Hideo Bally song that was amazing. A 29 Knives that was really amazing. You just missed it. Sorry. But yeah, I think we've gone through all the Bally songs at this point, really.
Those three, yeah.
Oh, here's a Jones Knives. It's got a carbon fiber inlay. Let's check that out. This is for you, 50
Blades.
Oh,
that's that Tonto.
Oh, no, we already saw this one. Yep, this one's really cool, too.
Sweet.
That's the carbon fiber inlaid one. So we'll stick this one back. But yeah, I think we went through... Oh, I know, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. We'll bring back that.
We'll crack those back out.
Yeah, that Japanese one was really, really impressive.
Oh, that's the one.
Yeah, you want to do the Hinderer?
Let's do the Hinderer. That's a really cool Monkey Muster grab.
Nice. So yeah, in here is the custom MP1 Battlefield by Rick Hinderer. Super popular knife maker. Super nice guy too. I don't really know him all that well, but I always...
Rick's super friendly.
Yeah, yep. I shake his hand every show that I see him at, and he's always really...
Very personable guy.
Yeah, he is. Wow, this is insane.
So, the story behind this is really neat. So this is a Battlefield Rescue build. At first glance, you think, wow, this knife looks a little strange. So every part of this knife is Battlefield Rescue parts, physically removed from the battlefield in Afghanistan, brought back to Rick, and he machined it into this knife.
Do you guys hear that?
Literally every single part is why it looks like that.
Yeah, here, show these guys. This is insane.
So everything on here is from the battlefield.
I think I need that.
The blade, the pocket clip. I believe the story is even the fasteners.
What are we watching here? Oh, hey, frag out. Well, I'm over here. This is endless. I'm over here at PVK Vegas, and they've got a bunch of insane custom knives and insane Bally songs and stuff. So we're just kind of showing them off. I get to put my hands on them, so I'm really excited about that. This one in particular that you're asking about, I don't know if you heard us talking, but Rick Hinderer custom, and the entire knife is comprised of parts that were scavenged from the battlefields out in Afghanistan. So really impressive piece.
Really, really impressive.
Yeah, me too. My little registered nurse, Casey. Yeah, that's really an amazing piece with so much history. Obviously.
That's exactly, yep.
Yeah.
The blade, like, the finish it looks rough, and then you hear the story of the knife, and you're like, okay, that's amazingly awesome.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, it builds so much fun into the knife, knowing that everything, you know, survived, or in some cases barely survived, a war.
Yeah, exactly. Which also, I think, lends itself to some of the usability, which we were talking about in the first, our first live feed.
Yeah, like that, look at that. That is a total, like, you could use that? Absolutely.
Absolutely use this.
You know, and that would almost honor the piece just as much, you know?
Oh, sure. And, you know, that's kind of, that's what I love about some of these knives, especially something like this with all this history, is being able to actively use it, and then people wonder, and then you explain, and then their mind is blown that, like, they had no idea knives were like this. You know, they figured they're used to their, you know, whatever, you can just go buy a $20 knife or whatever. And then, you know, they've learned and they're, wow, that's impressive. I had no idea. But yeah, so this is a killer piece.
That's really neat.
Is this one live on PVK right now?
Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, so apparently this one is actually available on PVK.com as we are doing this live feed. Pat, what did it go for? Yeah, would be worth having. Knives are a tool meant to be used. That's right.
Yep.
That's right.
Hashtag carry customs.
Yeah. Yeah, carry customs. That's no. Yeah. I think, who is it? My good friend we talk about a lot, Thug Knife. he started that hashtag use your shit.
Oh, and is he the originator?
I think so. Okay. I'm pretty confident right. He is, yeah.
I use that hashtag, so it's good to know who started it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. So anyways, yeah, this is an awesome piece, and we want to start building that hashtag carry customs.
Carry customs.
Yeah, fruit and carry those things, guys.
They're meant to be used.
Yeah. Yeah. And all this time I have a Kershaw in my pocket. Hey, there's nothing wrong with that. Hey, Rat Bastard and Michelle, the couple, are both in here separately. That's cool. Are you guys in the same room together, or is somebody somewhere else and you're both
watching the live feed side by side? Yeah. Double, triple inception? Whoa.
Rat Bastard's in the bathroom and Michelle's in the living room. What's up, guys? So let's move on. I know I want to get to this. But
that's
this is amazing.
That's your call. I'm gonna leave that if you wanna.
Yeah, we'll keep going.
Okay. We got some more Monkey Muster stuff.
Yeah, let's check out this Bob Terzola.
The great and mysterious. Oh wow.
Yeah.
Absolutely the father of tactical folding knives.
That's actually, I wanted to say that to my followers. You know, tactical folders, who knows when they would have started being made if it weren't for this guy right here. Bob Terzola, he's the legend. And yeah, this is an exquisite piece here. I can't even believe it's all Damascus bolstered. And what is
super lucky to get that?
No kidding. What is bottom part here? Do we even know?
We'd have to ask
Bob.
Yeah, if you're watching,
I know you're watching my feed right now.
It's live, and I totally don't remember off the top of my head. I'm having a brain fart.
It's amazing,
but it's gorgeous.
Yeah.
Super smooth, really hardy. Like that knife, that's a great custom by Bob. But you can see the lines of that knife being like a super battle knife. It's incredibly beefy, overbuilt.
It is. It's
like
so
in the hand, you're like, this is a serious piece right here. Even in his customs, that shows through. You know, serious liners, the bolsters. Like that's a beefy blade.
Yeah, it is. You guys can see in there. I'm hoping. Oh, it's kind of blurry. Sorry. But really incredible. Very cool to be able to finally handle one of his knives. You know, I handled one at a show once, but I can't remember. It was a while back. This is a really, really cool one.
That's very, very nice to have that. Very cool to see Bob say hi. Say, what's up, man? Still at it.
Oh,
killing
let me see.
It. Show me the black snow. Right.
All right, let's see. Is this... Okay, it's unfroze. So we're good.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, my phone froze a little bit. But we're good now. All right, we're back. Yeah, I do blame Rat Bastard. What else do we
have? Bomb in the feed.
What else do
we got over there?
Oh, that's the Hidetoshi. 50 Blades, are you still here? When 50 Blades comments back in, we'll reopen that one. But until then... What do you got over there?
I got a Kirby Lambert. Open that.
Oh, yeah. Actually,
that's neat.
When we were doing the first live feed, I got a question in the feed if we had any Kirby Lamberts here. And holy smokes, this is unreal.
Absolutely.
Yeah, wow, guys. So here's a Lambert. For those who are asking and interested, this is an unbelievable... Well, now that I see this, I see why everybody's asking about these. The detail is incredible. That copper pivot collar. The backspacer's floating. Yeah, this is a really cool piece. I'm gonna go to fire. It's Damascus steel. And yeah, look at that compound grind. Yeah, this is awesome. Can you guys see this pretty good?
The Damascus on that is absolutely next level.
Yeah.
The grinds, the way that part of it's polished and part of it's that classic Damascus is really nice. It's beautiful.
Come on. Yeah, here. Tell me a little bit about this one.
So this is a super special piece by Lambert. You know, got that compound grind is the new super popular. Everybody wants to see that.
Yeah.
Polished Damascus, partially etched, really nice. Sort of see the classic Lambert choil with a little bit of that flipper in there, and something that, you know, I've only handled a few Lamberts, but they all have a very similar form in the hand, which is super comfortable.
Yeah, it's super comfortable, I noticed.
With the thumb ramp sort of curving up on the blade like that. Just really nice. Everything you expect from a maker who's definitely been in the game for a very, like, you know, the longer you're at any craft, the better it gets. That floating backspacer, though, it's just, I don't think, come to think of it, I don't know off the top of my head, I'm sure someone will yell at me if I'm wrong.
Uh-oh. We gotta restart one of the live videos.
I'm sure someone will correct me, but a floating backspacer is a pretty rare thing.
Are those Protec pieces?
Yeah, you don't see them too often. We got one of the Protecs right here.
Sure. Ones I ripped the design.
Oh,
I don't know where that is.
Yeah, where did I see
them? The silver pieces.
Is my face showing up?
There we go.
Hi. That's hilarious, saying is there a possibility you've seen this man. You're funny. This is actually the first time I've ever held a Kirby Lambert. I see all his stuff. It's always a little too dressy for my personal taste, to be honest, but God, now that I've handled it, I see what the fanaticalness is all about. This is really remarkable. Kirby Lambert, good job, man. This is really an amazing piece.
Yeah. Super nice bolster work too. I love the classic bolsters.
Yeah.
The white micarta and the dark bolster makes for, like you said, a really nice dress piece.
Yeah, and the contrast is really sharp. I like he pulls some brightness back out with the pivot. Yeah. So yeah.
Little totally pivot collars are nice.
Bally Bawang. Are you guys knife collectors? Absolutely not.
What are you talking about? That's crazy.
Yeah. Would give you nice that idea. I collect pencils and pens. I'm just messing with you. I'm not being a douche. Yes, I do collect knives.
Getting to epic pieces.
Yeah.
Wait, let me see.
Yeah, RU Knife, nice price too. Yeah, so obviously you're on the PVK.com website right now, scoping stuff out. That's awesome. Yeah, we're just having a good time with them, Bally, and showing them off.
Knock them around.
Yeah, yeah. So, you're a curvy Lambert. again, if you guys are on, because it sounds like some of you guys are on the pvk.com website and checking some stuff out in real time. So if you see something on there that you want us to show you up close and personal, and make a video of or whatever,
then we can
call it out in the comments, and we'll pull it up. So yeah, you want to pull something crazy out?
This is like, so we were talking this earlier on the feed. This guy. So this is the APM.
Yep.
This is
Instant Pound.
Yeah.
Cam, Instant Pound. No, I don't think he's on right now. He's gonna be bummed that he missed this.
So this is absolutely.
It's like a piece of history here.
Right. So this is marked 97.
Yeah.
And
Microtech.
It's gorgeous.
Who I'm pretty confident most of you guys didn't start hearing about until like the past couple of years. They've been in the knife game for like 30 years or something outrageous. I'm probably being dramatic. But there you go.
So at first glance it really is just it's a mini Halo, but it represents a lot more. It represents like the beginning of like the Halo game,
if you want to
go with that. And this hasn't been seen on the internet in a very long time. So this is like, I know everyone's like an internet historian. Everybody knows everything about everything.
Oh wow, it feels amazing.
Like that knife predates the internet.
Yeah.
1997, a year after the internet totally exploded. That hasn't been seen on the internet in more than a decade. Was the last time I could find any history about that knife.
And I believe it too.
So
it was made in 1997. Yeah. There was, this was
none of us
some
were
dude's house.
Yeah,
you know, it's one of those things where like when you try something for the first time and it's the best thing that there is,
then you're like, how do I go back to everything
else? It's just effed up.
Else?
Yeah, you're,
like,
everything else is done. And holy shit, guys! I don't normally curse, but wow. Hey, full-grown midget is in the house. What's up, Anthony? Good, bad. Good in taste, bad in coming back. You're so funny. Willie. But yeah, so Black Snow Custom. I'm gonna fire this thing. This is crazy. It's a Zerku tie, pivot collar, Zerk pivot, Zerk bolsters, Zerku tie, freaking handles overlaid.
Just to the max.
Yeah, with a Zerk pocket clip. And it's two-tone Zerk. It's like this polished or satin, hand satin, Zerk with like a bead glass Zerk underneath. Like this is extremely complex. Natty, Black Snow, if you're watching this, holy shit. This is unreal. Yeah, sorry about that compressor in the back.
A little bit of air compressor.
That's all right.
It's got a floating Zerku tie back spacer.
Okay, so there's that floating spacer.
Yeah, right. The super elusive that we just showed back to back.
That's all right.
No, this is unreal. Ooh. Holy mother of God, I got to do that one more time. Yeah. All right, Natty. If you're watching this video, I don't care how long I have to wait.
There you go.
One.
On the list?
Yeah, get me on the list. This is crazy. This is crazy. It feels really good in the hand. I'm sorry I'm not even letting you handle
no,
this.
No, you go for it.
This is really awesome, guys. So,
That definitely, going for close-ups on that one. That blade is just, what's really nice is pretty much everything about it, but the roundness of the spine on the top of the blade, big sweep and
it's
the
a crown spine.
It's just
you've got this giant sweep here. The attention to detail is unreal, which I mean you kind of I guess would expect at a knife of this caliber, but holy shit, when you see it in person you're just like, what?
Then you can really hone in on the details. And I mean again, that's cool. It's a Sabotage. So cool to see a liner lock, you know?
Yeah.
It makes for a really clean side, and it really brings out just a beautiful lock side in that knife.
Yeah, this is really, really incredible. I'm going to get up for some close-ups of this thing, so we'll show you guys. This is the Black Snow Custom Sabotage Zerkutai, which is a mixture of zirconium and titanium. For some of you guys in my feed that you know, they're more the gun guys but are kind of interested. It's really impressive how they make that. And then, you know, this Damascus blade is just crazy. Can we get a close-up on it for the YouTube guys? Yeah. Ooh. Look at this. This is just insane.
Like, every angle that knife catches the light is it's gorgeous.
Yeah, this is, you know, I'm not normally into full dress knives, but this is really, really, really impressive. You guys see that?
Like, the covering of a knife in Damascus, in photographs it's one thing, but then having it in the hand, then you're just like, oh my God, It makes you appreciate whatever it is, Mokutai, Zerkutai, Damascus, that much more when it catches the light. Like, there's something about photographs that can't... Okay, good photographs, yes, but in the hand, a Damascus is
gorgeous. Yeah, no, you really got to see how the polish refracts the light or reflects the light versus the dark pieces that absorb it, and it just creates this insane contrast. Like, it is... absolutely insanity. That's looking pretty good there for you guys. Hopefully you can see it. Right. DJ K-Dog, $700. No.
Throwing offers out.
Yeah.
Not quite.
I'm going to just leave that there.
Yeah, it's a beautiful centerpiece, actually. I'm just kind of...
just leave that there for you guys. All. Yeah. T-S-W Agar. It is very sexy. And yeah, that pivot is amazing. Baseball card, no ball. Willie Nissen. You guys are hilarious. So, Black Snow Customs, that Sabotage, it's one of the hottest knives on the market right now. And this one in particular is unlike any of the other ones I've ever seen, with the Zerkutai and the Zerk everywhere. and the Damascus blade. That's wild, man.
Yeah, sabotage, really nice. You know, this was also my first sabotage to handle, and
was it?
You know, it's really hard not to fall in love. You know, it's hard not to.
It is.
The fit in the hand for me was definitely my first, just like
kind of it's melts in
it's
your hand.
So like, out of everything we looked at, I don't know. This is really, I have to say, aside from a stitch, I have a, you know, personal affection for stitches, but this is
for good reason.
Yeah, like, this is really comfy. Like,
Yeah, I like the like kind of kukri. It's got that forward rig.
Yeah, I know. Like you want to chop stuff.
Yeah,
you're like,
chop
all right, like let's
it.
Let's do this. Like I'm ready.
That's right. I'm just gonna take that open. to every steakhouse dinner I ever have. They're gonna offer me their steak knives, and I'm gonna be like, no.
No, I brought my own. Thank you kindly.
Yeah, appreciate that.
I brought my own. That's the hashtag knife guy. Knife guy dinner. When you go out to dinner, you're just like, all right.
Yeah, yeah.
That's like Josh and I go out to dinner, and we're just like piling our knives out and like taking pictures. Like, yep. No, I just brought a combat trude on to the steakhouse. It's
yeah,
fine.
Yeah.
It's totally fine. That's all right. That's okay. Waiter's like, can I help you? Like, no, we're good. No, that's fine.
That's
just,
right.
I brought my own. It's all right.
Yeah. And I've done that before, which is kind of embarrassing, but I'm like, I don't care. And I think I look like a little bit of a crazy person, but yeah, like some people are like, really are like, wow, that's really beautiful or amazing or whatever. And then other people are just like, you know, like, okay, grab your kids and let's get
yeah, like,
this place.
Like those men have
yeah.
scary knives. Like, I don't know what's going on. Like,
yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, a full-grown midget. Can I sell my kidney? I don't know.
You can. Will we accept it as payment is the question.
Yeah, no, I mean, we'll take it as a down payment.
Yeah, down payment would work well.
Yeah. DJ K-Dog, $800? No. This isn't my knife. This is going to be for sale, actually.
That's up now, right?
PVK.com.
No, it will be soon to be live. We'll
right.
take your kidney, though.
Right.
Yeah, I'll take a Red Bull. Thank you. So it is going to be for sale. It's not live right now. But if this thing was anything under $5,000, I'd just buy it right here so you guys wouldn't even have a chance at it. And
what's,
I apologize
what's your time
for that. Oh, I guess I'm going to commit to it right now, aren't I?
It's 58.
Oh, so yeah. So it's 5,800. There you go. So kidney and a few other things.
Maybe both your kidneys.
Yeah.
If they're in good standing health.
Thanks
know?
For the Red Bull. Mm-hmm. Hate when people look at you crazy when you bring them. Oh, yeah, I know.
See, somebody else understands that.
Yeah.
That, like, quick, get all your knives, take pictures, cut stuff.
Yeah, I've always been a kind of a degaff kind of a situation like that. I pull my knives out and I put them on street signs and lampposts.
You were outside a couple minutes.
I was outside. Stay tuned to my feed because I took some really crazy photos of this DLC Borka stitch right out on, like, I mean, 100 people within eye view, and they're all looking at me like kind of creepy. People are pulling their daughters aside. And,
I don't know what that guy's doing.
Yeah, yeah. And I was like, I just don't care. But yeah, so
that's good walking video though.
Oh yeah, I posted that walking video. That's funny. But yeah, it's kind of weird when people look at you crazy. But then again, you know, you're holding a knife out in public, so it could be creepy. These guys don't know that they're $5,000, $3,000, $1,000, a few hundred dollars,
yeah.
Whatever they are. They don't understand it. They just see a knife.
They're just like, oh, okay, like that's all right.
Yeah, but yeah, we got some of these, some more of these Ultratech OTFs. This is a really special one, so let's keep that aside. And, you got some hot shots. Yeah.
So this is what we call the Blue Wave Geisha, with the pretty geisha lady on the front there.
That's one of my favorite pieces.
That is a satin finish Spartan blade with laser geisha on the blade, which is really neat because when we run the laser at a proprietary settings,
of course,
we can pull color out of the steel.
Yeah,
and so
I noticed this
one's like a nice green yellow sad fish. I know you like the Spartan blades are like.
I love the Spartan blade.
It's a great design.
I'm glad you agree because
like
I think,
a micro sword.
Yeah, some people are I guess on the fence about it, which I have yet to hear, but. But someone told me that they're like, oh no, there's a lot of people that don't like that. And I'm like, are you kidding me? This is the coolest effing knife blade, I mean, it's like you said, it's like a little mini sword. You got cutting edge on both sides, and it's just menacing looking. Yeah, I love this one here. I'm gonna bring this one in for a close up for the YouTube guys.
Nobody flagged that post because there's breasts.
Oh yeah, there's boobies on this. Sorry. Wait, hold on. Yeah, so there's the geisha, beautiful with the kanji on the blade, or katakana actually. What is that? Ancient Mandarin. And then, oh, we went out of focus. And then the really cool laser wave design on the back, which is amazing. You guys see that, all right? Yeah. Deploy it again because it's just so cool. So satisfying.
That dual action mechanism, snappy.
Yeah, it's really a lot of fun. I mean, people just don't understand how convenient it is to have that option. It's just, it's in your pocket, you pull it out, you need it, you just push the button, the blade comes out, you cut what you want to do, and then you retract and put it back in your pocket again. You don't have to worry about anything. It's really awesome.
Leave that out. Bam. And this is a new one. So this isn't even on the site yet. I don't even think many people have seen this. This is a really vintage looking, that's what I love about it. It's like, it looks like this came from, you know, 500 Japan, like really old school.
That's actually where that came from. that is a,
Oh, like honestly, that's where the image came from?
Yeah. Oh, wow. That is a customer submitted beautiful piece of artwork that is absolutely authentically probably, I don't know how old, but a painting.
That's amazing.
That was requested. So
it's got the little fans on the back. Yeah.
Yep. That's our new, we call it the Geisha One.
Yeah, this is really, really nice.
Which is, you know, you have like the sort of neo-Tokyo geisha, and you have the very classic representation that you might see on a scroll.
Yeah, exactly.
Where that's from.
Yeah, I like both of them, actually. I really like this one because of it looks old and ancient, and I'm into that. But I really love how, like, she is, you know, she's looking real sexy and provocative in her pose.
The pose on this is...
Yeah, that pose is what does it.
It's killer.
Yeah.
Very, very sensual pose on that.
Yeah. Wait, hold on, I missed... Nipple. Faulty Ply, what's up, man? I don't know if you bounced out already. I missed your comment like a few minutes ago. Yeah, we were doing some valleys. We'll do some more. We'll pull out, I think, probably the Incredible Hulk again. And there's a Mortal Kombat Tachyon 3 that I really, really like. I got a buddy of mine. Actually, a lot of the Valleysong guys know him. He works on Mortal Kombat. He's one of the combat engineers over there. He's a pretty good friend of mine.
Oh, and, right.
Yeah, no, I originally come from the video game industry.
Is that right?
And so, yeah, so a lot of, I still have a lot of contacts there. Like, I got buddies that work for Call of Duty, and I just made a post in relation to that, actually, to help them out.
All right.
But yeah, bearings or washers? Absolutely washers. Gavinator is another Ballysong flipper I love. Sorry, I'm getting all over the place here because you guys are quick. And I'm like jumping topics, but yeah, the Mortal Kombat Tachyon. I'm gonna pull that one out actually. So Faulty Ply, Gavinator. Yeah, get out the ballies. All right, let me get. Saiji is a really good flipper. I really like him a lot too. Let me get that Mortal Kombat Tac 3. That thing's really cool. We'll get Incredible Hulk and Batman. And MK is right there. Alright, guys. Boom.
There they are. Highly, highly colorful tachyons.
Yeah, those things are great. What else do we have in the way of...
There was actually
You guys see my Richard Eames chair that they've so graciously provided me with here at PVK? Only the best. Got OTB firearms, only the best firearms. This is like OTB knives. What is that? Yeah, that's beautiful.
That's black on blue.
Satin blue with black. Yeah, this is really awesome.
Where the heck is a Superman at?
The contrast. Actually, yeah, I saw a Superman. Yeah. I think it's... There's one in the vault.
Quick stall.
And there's one, yeah. We'll get a Superman out too. But this is a really cool black on blue. This is Batman. This is Incredible Hulk. Do the green glow. Yeah, the Batman's really cool, Faulty. Here, I'll show it. I'll give you a kind of a close up of it.
Yeah, I really like this Batman, the freaking Bruce Wayne. I try to relate to Bruce Wayne as much as possible in my personal life. So anything Batman, I'm all about it.
Trainers.
Oh yeah, yeah, and the TAC 3 trainer. So if you're, God, this has a really great weight to it. This is a custom.
That is a custom.
Yeah, I can tell. This is really great. It's got the channel. Well, they all do, but this has the custom deal inside the channel there. Can you see that? No, yeah, there's no way the camera will focus, but it's awesome. So yeah, you can practice all your moves and not worry about cutting yourself. It's great. Yeah. So yeah, lots of fun. And I think some of these tacks are available right now on PVK.com. So if you see any of these that you want, you can jump on. And if you see any on the website, as I said before, let us know. We'll pull it out and show you. But where is the MK? I really like the Mortal Kombat.
Oh, that's the Mortal Kombat. That's
Seiji.
In-house laser work on that.
Seiji. Oh,
that's fun.
That was like Seiji, but yeah, Seiji. Awesome. Good to see you there, man. So this is the Mortal Kombat. Cue
Mortal Kombat.
Yeah. So yeah, this one's really pretty cool. And if my boy Portola is watching, what's his screen name? I'll have to remember, but he's the combat programmer on the Mortal Kombat. And also, he's got a new one coming out over there. What is it, with the DC Comics fighting game? It's all the same combat engine.
Wait, DC Marvel?
Yeah. Yeah, what? Nerds and my deal fellows, join together and help me. What is
Where
that
are
name?
You? What is the name of this?
This tax slip tight. Yeah, they're really, really amazing. Yeah. Full-grown midget fatality. Yeah, Faulty, I'd love to meet you in person, man. I really enjoy watching your videos. And
be
really cool to
Flippers.
Meet you
one day. Flippers. Where are the Vegas Flippers?
Yeah, we want to shout out again to Vegas
real.
Flippers.
That's absolutely a real offer.
Yeah, absolutely a real offer. If you are a flipper and you are in Las Vegas right now, stop what you're doing and come to PVK and hang out with us for a little bit. We want to do some live video feeds of some sick tricks. And wait, whoa, what was that one?
Oh, that popped up. That's the in-house laser.
Yeah, this is cool.
That's the Reaper. The Reaper on a black stonewashed. Or
yeah, you guys can see that.
Elliptic.
Yeah, it's the Grim Reaper on black handles. There we go. Sorry, the camera keeps focusing and unfocusing. But yeah, this is really cool.
Oh, it is stonewashed on apocalyptic. Yep. Yeah, you know that.
This probably looks cool moving.
It's like a blur.
Yeah, just like all light.
That Type 3 hard coat on those, really.
So super durable.
Oh yeah, when you put that under a laser though, it's not only durable, but Type 3 just lasers beautifully.
Oh,
it's really
so durable. It just gets crisp, right?
Yeah.
Nothing bleeds.
Yeah. The world of colorful ballet songs.
Oh, it looks like Gavinator is local Las Vegas flipper.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. I don't think I can make it tonight. Figure it out.
Yeah.
Well, figure it out.
Send us an email. Shout out. Reach out. It'd be great to have flippers. Come down, get some guys flipping on the weekends out front of the store, figure it out.
Yeah, that would be great, actually.
Reach out, DM me on the PBK Instagram.
Yep.
That's that Superman one.
Oh, yeah, there's Superman. Let's see this Superman. Let's see this Superman. I got to do an aerial with this one, right?
Yeah, and I'm sitting back.
I'm just kidding. I'm not going to do that. We got too much stuff in here. It's, like, dangerous, and I will F it up. But, yeah, this is crazy, man. This is, like... This probably looks really good in a flipping video.
Actually, yeah.
Those colors just blurring and speeding along like that?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Like, that's pretty neat. Oh, this is
Hulk, yeah, the Incredible Hulk is really cool. Yeah,
Gavinator could come by and freaking flip this thing like a mad crazy guy. That would be really amazing to watch. Same with the Incredible Hulk, which I've dubbed
this is so neat.
The Lambo.
I you know, I could get behind that.
But yeah, I love it because it's green and purple, but that purple is like vampire purple. It's like, you know.
Yeah, at first glance, you're like, is that black? And you're like, no, it's...
It's black until you catch that faint, and then you're like, wait a second.
There it is.
Yeah, that Mortal Kombat one is really, really cool. Yeah, the Superman one is a little crazy, but again, I think it would look really cool, like, flipping.
Cruising in the sky, man.
Yeah, and then the Reaper. Is the Reaper up, like, for sale?
Yes. Nice. Yep, those in-house laser customs are all in the PVK exclusive section.
Sweet.
I wonder what we could do with this Incredible Hulk one.
Absolutely, we'll have the Black Widow ones. 100%. Yeah, are you knife? Yeah, it is fun, but it's very time-consuming. I watch some of these guys like Gavinator and CG, or what did he say? How do you pronounce it? CG? Yeah, CG. And Ego's Death, who I always talk about because he's my absolute favorite, and then Nardath and Slash and Cuts and all those really great guys. I can't figure it out. I'm like, how do you guys have time to learn those insane moves? Like,
commitment, man.
Yeah, I gotta like.
And lots of band-aids.
I gotta retire or something. I've cut myself.
All right.
I've.
You heard it. He's retiring. That's it.
Yeah, so I can focus full time on ballet song flipping.
The one true calling.
Yeah. Oh.
The live video ended, so it's.
Oh.
I'm gonna redo
greens.
It.
Oh, that's still going. I don't know why that times out. I'm surprised Instagram put a. Maybe that's like a default, so you have to. Someone has to be there manning it.
Yeah.
Also, I forgot that this. This
custom trainer.
The custom trainer actually comes with the original hidden clip that we sell you on, like, Mark 1 sigils.
Yeah, because I. You know what? Some of these guys could correct me. Seigi. There we go. If I'm wrong, but I think Derek may have engineered that. Or Grant, or Gavin Hawk, or obviously, probably, Tony.
That's just not gonna focus.
Double no.
Kind of neat.
Yeah, full-grown midget, help me. Who engineered that pocket clip? Because it is really cool.
It's pretty neat.
Yeah, Seiji, I'll remember it. But yeah, anywho, I know, I just need to pick up. Where we left off is I've cut myself 100 times. Like, I don't mind cutting myself. As a matter of fact, if you go way back in my feed, you'll see I've made pictures where my hands are all bloody from cutting them from flipping, especially when I got the copper scales from Flytanium.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yep. That thing was insane. I just, like, within 30 seconds, whack, yeah, just guillotine the hell out. I mean, that thing was a gusher. But, yeah, I like getting the war wounds, actually. It's just the time.
Yeah.
Like, it truly takes so much dedication, and I totally commend you guys that are over the top with the ballet song manipulation. I love watching it. It's so cool. And I hope to get there one day. I just, you know, it's hard because it's time consuming. But
in time.
Yeah. So I'm glad we got some ballet songs back on the table again, because that seems to be one of the hottest topics, are all these ballet songs. But how do you guys feel about Borka blades and Borka stitches?
Oh, man.
Because I get a lot of activity when I post up a stitch. It seems to be one of everybody's favorite knives to see. Let me see here. Who is this? Chris Suarez. The big knife, this one here, that's a Black Snow Customs Sabotage. It's over the top insane with Zerk Utai, Zerk, two different finish, so two-tone Zerk. Zerker type pivot collar, backspacer, and full domestic polished Damascus blade. Yeah, that's an insane piece. Super duper insane. We talked about that one for probably the longest amount of time. Yeah, triple dollar signs. You need like two or three more dollar signs on that comment, Chris.
And then you'll be
you'll be a little more accurate. It's over the top. Do you want to see it up close? I'm happy to show it to you while we get this one ready here, because this is an incredible piece.
The thing about it is it's just crazy.
It's crazy. It's crazy. But yeah, here's the Sabotage. Some more. Sorry.
The Zerkutai is just insane. Blending zirconium with titanium and getting those colors right, and I mean, it's just like mind blowing. And the action is, you know, really cool, really effortless.
Look pretty smooth.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice content, everything.
Everything about it. This is like everything a knife really should be, in my opinion. It's awesome.
Yeah, super dope. What's in the box? Yeah, are you not? This is. That's right.
What is that?
All right, Brad Pitt. Here we go. Yeah, I really want to show this thing off. I wish I would have had this out earlier when there was daylight out so I could take some pictures. But this is the really, really, really insane Borka stitch. And this is my first time seeing it in person, and I'm kind of just taking it in for a second. This Lightning Strike carbon fiber inlay is just bonkers. And then of course,
look at that.
So that's
what we were talking about earlier. That Hammond is done by Ryan Weeks. It's like a triple collaboration. It's just, I think it's breathtaking.
It's amazing.
They did a great job.
I just learned about Ryan Weeks today. I just started following him. And Michelle Borka, like the Borka of all Borkas. This thing is truly insane. Holy fucking bean soup, Batman. It really is. I'll show you up close. The Hamon is nuts, and it's done by Brian Weeks.
Yep.
And the guy does like ultra traditional Hamon work. It's really.
We get questions on that. Like, well, why isn't it more of a high contrast? And it's like, well, honestly, traditionally, when you look at ancient swords, it wasn't a super high contrast thing. That is absolutely reminiscent of a traditional style.
Yeah, old samurai sword. I mean, this, when I look at this, I feel like I'm looking at a like history changing samurai sword. This is really insane. Yeah, let me show the YouTube guys here. This one is actually live on PVK.com right now. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. It is so remarkable. This is like one of the end-alls, you know? It's got extra texturing on the stabilizer there. Side pivot. So yeah, this is actually one of the main pieces I really wanted to see today. So this is like making me very, very smiley at the moment. But yeah, deploy that thing, man. It's so cool.
Oh. Jirhas, yeah, you know what? I'm a monster fanatic, to be honest. but I'll take me some sugar bowl any day. Man, I'd chop some shit up with that. Yeah, me too. Are you knife? I am too. They thought it electrocuted me. Well, yeah, that's about the most beautiful stitch I've personally ever seen. That's what we were doing today, guys. Yeah, at least you got to check out a bunch of cool stuff. Not even ruined by leaps and bounds. Oh, yeah, absolutely agree with that, Jim. You're spot on. Is that the California legal version? Yeah, no. Is it? Yeah, the California legal version is literally a slice of pepperoni pizza. It's not really even a knife.
This is the California legal version of everything?
Yeah.
Right here? You guys in Cali? There you go.
Put that in my...
I got one for you right there.
There it is. California legal. Oh, this little stubby thing. This reminds me of that Stunner or whatever by Menovade.
Oh.
That guy's cool.
Yeah, yeah. That was a neat piece, actually.
Yeah. It's got crazy action. It fired right out. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Anyways, guys, so that's about it, really. I hope you guys enjoyed the live feed. And if anybody wants to jump on pvk.com really quick and pick something out that you want to see before we sign off, let me know. There's they got some really cool DB customs. I've had that DB custom with my name, Endless, engraved on it for quite a while, and when I do, it's a Mustafa, it's got the two pyramids on the top. I really, really like that nuck. PVK has got some of those here. Actually, you know, it's right here. I'm gonna pull it out.
Those nuck guys. One last nuck hurrah.
Yeah, because I really like those. They've got some stuff by a good friend of mine, Knuckle.
Oh, that's
Knuckle Tools. Yeah,
Norm.
Yeah, Norman.
Nuka Norm, man.
So this is actually brass. This is the Mustafa, so this is actually what I have.
Serious.
Mine's two-tone, but this is like brass amazingness. So I got some of these on there.
Oh, guys, we're asking about what's in the glass case, so here are some,
we got,
some goodies.
We got a couple of these TKI sets left that have this
that's the,
super limited, ultra custom
Shotgunning the Red Bull. I will
Psypop by Burnley.
Yeah.
Which is it's a collab, and it's got a really beautiful jewelry style skull on there.
Yeah, and if you can't tell, like right away, well, at least because I have a Prometheus Design Works steel flame Zippo, I could just immediately pick up the steel flame on here. So this is Burnley and steel flame for the TKI show. And this is actually the first time I've held a Psypop. I mean, they've been so popular.
And that actually, that comes with a GSD sheath.
Oh, and GSD, that's right.
Yeah.
GSD did the sheath.
That's pretty neat.
But yeah, so these are really comfortable. So you got this.
Psypops are nice.
This is really cool. And then you've got the little bottle opener there, which is what you will use it for 100% of the time.
That's right. that is the only, yep. Uh-huh.
So yeah, really, really cool piece.
Knuck love.
Whoops. All right, here's that. Yeah, so did you guys get
you don't wanna
to
just
pull out that
just because we're at
dude, my boy John EOS, I don't know if you're watching or not, but
probably. What are you working or something?
He's always working. EOS is
EOS
awesome.
In the house with the Whaler and the Daily Badass collaboration.
I agree, Red Bastard.
The Lobo in Tiffany Blue, that's what he calls that.
Yeah, the Tiffany Blue Neck, so this is for your girl. Or for
the questionable man. But yeah, these are really cool. I love John's work. I actually have a squid on the way from them. I can't wait for it to get here. We were just kind of going over options over Easter. And so yeah, I'm excited to get that. And then that's the...
This is the Whaler. We have a couple of surgeons on hand of John's.
Yeah, where is it?
They're in that safe that opens once every couple of hours, unfortunately. But they're live up there, and we're happy to say that we're absolutely gonna be carrying most of John's stuff at the shop.
Yeah.
So we'll definitely be an exclusive dealer for a lot of EOS stuff, which is great.
his wallet,
everything. We've got his beads. Got a lot of stuff about EOS.
Yeah, EOS, great guy. The guy is a machine wizard. Love his work. The bomb beads are really cool. But yeah, I wanted to show, grab that lens light, because it matches this. Yeah.
The camo.
Yeah, the lens light camo.
That's...
Yeah, so freaking cool. And then here is the lens light
Strider. YouTube guys, can see that. And then my guys, I took some really great shots out on the Las Vegas Strip with this Strider knife right here, the Lens Light Edition. they turned out really good. And one of them you guys are going to love. It's a kind of a only in Vegas type shot. And I'm happy to post it. Happy to post it. But yeah, so really, really cool. I'm definitely like eyeballing this thing. But
when in Vegas post.
Yeah. Yeah, the one in Vegas post. That's right. So yeah, this is a really cool set. This is on PVK.com right now, too. Oh yeah, you gotta see the other side too. It's got the little like eyes. But anyways, yeah, guys. So that's gonna pretty much be it. What time is it? It's getting late, man. I was like
8:45 on the West Coast, which is
yeah.
What is that? Midnight.
Yeah, Jim. I totally agree. Like it's actually even better in person. You can kind of see it.
Oh, that digital camo lens. Yeah, is nuts.
It's nuts. The contrast is absolutely bonkers, and then I love the convex, like projector style.
That light. On a side note, that light is awesome.
Yeah, it's freaking.
Like I carry that in my backpack every day to work, and you know, people ask me a lot about laser stuff. Like that lens light bounces around in my bag with my other crap. Like laser work is laser work. It doesn't wear off.
It doesn't wear off.
It's not a coating. It's not a Cerakote. It's on there. It's burnt metal.
Yep.
So like I've had that for a year bouncing around my bag, and it looks pretty much just like that brand new one.
Yeah.
Those lens light guys, they're great.
Oh,
spherical lens technology.
ESPN Tim. I know the Stoneheads. I left those at home. And I'm kind of regretting it, to be honest. I didn't even bring anything except for what I was carrying, which is my Monroe guardrail and my Shark Nivco Edison Barajas Japanese Tanto, the Ryu, with all the Mokumi, which I absolutely love.
Shout out, everybody's in love with.
Yeah, everybody's loving this piece. I'm so happy that I brought it because everybody does like it. I don't know if it would kick my Hankos. Yeah, Hankos are insane. I've actually never handled one in person, but when I see them, I'm like, yeah, this is really insanely intricate and cool. So I'd love to see one of those in person. Yeah, this is more, I think, like a user. But yeah, no, it's cool to know that you carry that, actually. I'd obviously carry one, but I didn't know that most people would carry a Hanko because they're pretty... I think they're really sought out for, and they're really intricately detailed. but yeah, how many lumens for the flashlight? Actually, I don't know. It's probably on the registration card, or not the registration card, but the certification card. Lens Light Enterprises Inc. Lens Light. It doesn't even have a model number.
Trying to rake all the. It's engraved on the bezel. On the exterior part of the front bezel. I don't think it says lumens on it there, though.
No, it doesn't. But it actually, inside this projector, it actually has the Lens Light logo, which is really,
super cool.
Really cool touch, actually. I mean, it's absolutely meaningless, but the artistry behind it, I love that kind of stuff.
Yeah, so these finite touches, right?
Yeah, the finite touches, man. Really cool, actually. Yeah, I gotta see if you guys can see that. It's totally worth seeing.
You can see it. The Lens Light logo, you could barely see it. It's pretty vivid in person.
Yeah, actually I have mine.
Yeah, lumen, Jim's going into explanation of lumens. Lumens is very
high. You guys, this is exactly what, this is mine after a year of carry. It's like you can see the scratches, but the laser stuff doesn't wear out. I mean, this is like an extremely bright.
Brand new carried versus... carried in a sack full of crazy stuff.
Complete EDC gear. What you might imagine is actually in there.
Full grown midget. That is pretty common. Yeah, especially like for something of this size. 250, maybe 400 max. But you know, most weapon lights are 200 and 400, 300 even. And I test those out on myself just to see what I'm going to be doing to a potential attacker, and it'll stun you at night, especially. Since that's 1,000 lumens, but again, lumens isn't what makes a good light. Yeah.
We get into specifics. All right.
Go. Where can I get one? PVK.com. So www.pvk.com. But So, yeah, 1,000 lumens is like retina melting, which is pretty cool. Actually,
hyper bright.
I'll have to say, I do carry a 1,000 lumen during the day, just because with all the ambient light, I really want to make sure that I temporarily blind someone if I have to, and so that's why I carry 1,000 lumens just during the day. But 200, 250, 300 lumens is really bright at night. And again, as Jim was kind of saying, the clarity, when you whack somebody with a crystal clear light, it really, it shocks your senses. It's uncontrollable. And that's what's cool about EDC flashlights for personal defense. I'm very much an anti-violence guy. I mean, you know, I CCW, thankfully I've never had to use any of it, but I'm very, very anti-violence. I'm so anti-violence that, you know, I understand that it takes violence to end violence. And but that's why I like these flashlights, because you can absolutely, you know, unless somebody's just going crazy like have been happening lately, you know, if someone's trying to attack you, you can stun them with the light and blind them, and then you know, get away without having to hurt anybody. Or you can blind them and then you know, subdue them while you call the cops, which is even better.
Especially, if
but it's still anti-violence, so that's what I prefer.
If it's super dark, like we were in a club not too long ago, and the guards now carry high-powered like strobe weapon lights.
Yeah,
and you're like, you're in the club and you're like, oh, I'm having a drink. And the security guard is out of nowhere. This big dude is just like, bah, 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 and you're like, oh my god,
no,
like that is terrible.
It's an
uncontrollable. And the person who he was flashing at was just like, I have no idea what's going on.
No, you're legally blind.
He's like, brrr.
Yeah.
I'm just like,
yeah,
oh,
you're legally
man.
Blind for, you know, it's different for everybody, but you're absolutely legally blind. Thankfully, it's temporary. But, oh yeah, Jim wants to see his naked neighbor clearly through her window from the bushes without so much brightness that she sees where I am. That's why I use
okay.
night vision
yeah,
with infrared. That's something I've been using for about, I don't know, a year and a half now, Jim. I highly recommend it. Yeah, just throw the night vision on with your infrared illuminator, and nobody knows you're there. And you can even, you know, kind of, you're in your own privacy. Nobody knows, so you can do what you want.
I think Kat makes an infrared phone now.
Oh, yeah.
On a total side note, yep.
See?
Yeah.
We already know. Pervert level pro. Yeah, no, not only, you know, my next door neighbor, but many, many neighbors and
many neighbors,
people.
All
the but, let me see, I just missed one over here. Can I have a knife? Please. Diverted dragon. No, I believe in hard work. And no. I think if you were just given a knife, you wouldn't even appreciate it anyway.
I think.
Yeah.
When you give somebody something, unless it's a gift out of love or
yeah,
friendship,
yes, true
it's,
that.
It's really it's a non-appreciative.
Yeah, true that.
And on that note, and on that bombshell.
Yeah. You guys probably want to see the because I haven't taken any pictures of this yet. This is the the Strider Starlinger Killer. Again, I'm totally into this because of my younger brother, who I absolutely love. He's a big Jason Voorhees fan. We both really like horror movies. And, you know, being such a Strider fan, and this thing with the Starlinger Jason mask, dripping blood, and the really cool textured, multicolored G10, it looks like. Really kind of rugged, actually. I love it, the Jason mask bead. And then my favorite part is when I turn it over to the frame lock side and you've got the dripping blood everywhere, which is so awesome in my opinion. But yeah, so the Strider knives, Starlinger Killer. Just picked this up. I have not even taken a photo of this yet. So expect to see some pretty crazy photos of this in the near future. I took some really cool pictures out in the Las Vegas Strip and the little back alleyways of Las Vegas. If you can only imagine some of the things I found.
They are in my photos.
The dirty little cracks of the city.
Yeah, the dirty little cracks of the city, and I've tried to make it apparent in my photos on purpose. So stay tuned for those. I think you're all going to really, really enjoy that because I personally, I think it's great. Some of the things that I found and were absolutely sure, made sure of to put in my photos, so I'll make sure it's edited really crazy and that you guys enjoy them. So I did the lens light strider. I did the really cool stitch that has harsh contrast, like DLC blade with DLC hardware pocket clip. And that one was really cool. I took a lot of really good pictures of that. And a couple of really great pictures of the geisha, which he just picked up coincidentally. I really, really love this freaking geisha. It's so amazing. And the Spartan blade is just awesome as all hell. Yeah, hit that like button for this blade. This is actually on pvk.com. It's a limited number. I think there's like a dozen of them. So yep. Once they're gone, that's it. I don't mean to sound like a freaking knife telemarketer guy. Like, you know,
they
440
are...
stainless steel blade.
Get it yeah, now.
Get it now. Normally $3,000 on sale for $29.99.
Five easy payments of $6,000 and it's yours.
Yeah, exactly. So I don't mean to sound like that. I just, you know, I'm pretty passionate about it. I really like these geishas and, you know, being limited. Hold on, sorry, it's freaking blurry again. But yeah, so I don't know if you guys are sick of seeing the geisha or not, but I really love it. The lasered wave pattern on the back, and I love the Spartan blade. Oh, Jim's here. I hear a Hellcat outside.
Oh, is that what that is?
Yeah, he probably drove here.
He's scoot all the way over here to say hi?
Yeah. So geisha is live on pvk.com. And then actually, for those of you who are just kind of like tuning in now, this is this Mech Army spinner. I mean, the fidget spinners are all the rage. pvk.com, you can pick these up. They are really, really affordable in way of spinners, and it's like, it's really amazing. Balanced well. Really good bearings. It's freaking awesome. Yeah, so check those out.
I dig that.
Yeah, there's actually, there are some other versions. See, there's like a murdered out one that I really, really like. And then, you know, like a couple other different ones. But yeah, so you can check those out on pvk.com. Is Norman? Norman's probably asleep over there in the East Coast Canada region.
Up north region?
Yeah. He does these knuckos, which... you guys have seen in my feed a lot. Well, not recently, but I have them, and I love them. He does the knuckle skull, too, which is cool. That one's insane.
So this is neat. We're actually doing this Titanium Mogwai. We're doing a collaboration between PVK, Nuko, and Meats and Metals. And he's tricking out a bunch of Mogwai for us.
This is the Mogwai, which I actually have one of these. If you go way back in my feed, you'll see one. I think I took a picture with it, of it with my American Commie Cleaver that everybody lives. It was a collaboration between Era 3, and American Commie. But yeah, tell me. I kind of want to know a little bit more about this Mogwai you got with the triple collab.
Oh yeah, so actually through Impera, I found a great titanium aftermarket anodizer and customizer, Meats and Metals on Instagram. And so I did some work with him on some Janus, and then now we're working with him and Norm on some super, super custom runs of the Mogwai. So we're going to do like an orange peel finish. We're going to do a bunch of different colors and textures, which is going to be awesome. And so it'll be a really nice exclusive.
Yeah. And you can open 4 beers at once.
Dude, it's like, where else are you going to get that, right? Come on.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, it would be physically impossible to do that, so I apologize. But the thought
but in
nice.
A row.
In a row,
like,
yeah.
Just kind of roll them.
Touche.
You know?
Touche.
Like, everyone at the table is like,
Michelle,
how do I open
like that,
these?
Huh?
No problem.
Yeah.
Do you or have you ever EDC'd fixed blades? Oh, yeah. Actually, look.
What are you
Yeah. Yeah, I'm EDC'ing... Sorry. I'm EDC'ing my Monroe Knives guardrail, actually. So I keep my pocket knife that I use for like everyday cutting in my pocket,
but then I always do like to have a fixed blade on me, either placed on basically like the small of my back, so I can just reach around and pull it out in reverse grip, ready to go. Or occasionally like just gun holster style on my side, so I can easily grab it there too. I love EDCing fixed blades because they are really durable, and well, you know, every knife's pretty durable when it comes to that, but you don't have to question anything if the need arises. You know, if I've got to use this as a pry bar, I 3 years ago, I didn't, not this knife, but I rescued this girl who was in a car accident.
What?
Yeah, and her car was on fire.
What?
And I pulled her out of the car, and